Good morning friends, my name is Bhavesh Parmar and in our previous session we have just take the introduction about our computer science course. So how the marking distribution is there, the weightage of practicals, weightage of theory, then again in that paper 1, paper 2. So these things we have discussed in our previous session. So from today's session we are going to see our actual syllabus. So guys, we start with our first lesson, and the name of our first lesson is study of components and circuits. So guys, why we have to study electronics in paper second? Because as I told you yesterday, definition of computer, a computer is an electronic device which accept different kinds of data as an input, process on that data and gives output according to the user requirement. Okay, but what is our first statement? Computer is an electronic device. Means computer is made up from different kinds of electronic components. So which are these components are there? How these components works? So in 11th standard point of view, we have to study all of these basic components. So guys, we have to study 5 different electronic components, and generally by using these components we are using a different electronic circuits. So these electronic circuits work used at various places, like our computer, that is motherboard, then mouse, keyboard, hard disk, DVD, CD, printer, scanner. Even though if we see our TV remote, our TV, it also consists of electronic components and they use special electronic circuit. So that circuit is called PCB, that is printed circuit board. Okay guys, so which components they widely used, how they works, what are their limitations, what are their merits, advantages, that we are going to be discussed. So as I told you, we have to study 5 different electronic components, and these electronic components are classified into 2 category, that is passive component and active component. So in case of passive component, what happen? So these component do not have ability to process or amplify the signal. Means what guys? If we provide some signal to that particular circuit, and if they belongs to passive components category, then what happen? They just accept the signal as it is. But sometime what happen when we receives any signal, that signal may consist of some error. Error means what? There are improper signal. So what these components actually did, they do not process, just pass as it is. Okay, means what happen when we pass such kind of signals to that given circuit, then what happen? If that signal consists of error data, then which results into error output. Means you will never get a perfect output. Why? Because we received problematic data. So we never get 100% accurate data. So these kinds of components are called what? Passive components. And if we compare the cost of passive components, they are less expensive as compared to our second type of component, that is active component. So in case of active component, as the name suggests, active, they are smart and intelligent. Means what happen? If they receive the weak signal or error signal, then what they try to do, they can process on that signal, amplify it, means they modify the signal and then pass it to the circuit for better result. Is that clear? So there are 2 types of components. Which are those? First one is our passive component and second is our active component. Passive component do not have ability to process or amplify on given signal. So that's why cost point of view, they are less expensive in case of active component. So active component have ability to process on given data, they can amplify. So they reduce number of errors and you will get 100% accurate result. Okay, so these 5 components are classified in passive and active form. So on your board, on this board, you can just easily see that electronic components bifurcated into passive as well as active component. In passive component, there are three sub-components are there. In that, first one is what? Resistor. Second one is capacitor. Third one is inductor. And in active component, we have to study two different types of component. In that, first one is semiconductor devices. And the second one is tube devices. So these five components are categorized into passive as well as active components. So this is the basic structure of our electronic components. And these components widely used to manufacture different kinds of electronic circuit. Especially we used from, if we consider from computer form point of view, these components are widely used in our computer system. So now guys, in passive components, we have to study three different components. So which are those? Resistor, capacitor and inductor. So guys, in today's session, we are going to focus on first component, that is resistor. First component is resistor. It is represented by R. And this is the symbol for resistor. So guys, there are two types of resistor. First of all, fixed type resistor, and second type is called variable resistor. So especially what happened, fixed type resistors are also called carbon resistors, and their value is fixed. And if we see the cost point of view, they are less expensive. And the measurement unit of resistor is what, guys? So it is, resistance is measured in terms of ohm. So these are the basic introductory part. Then what do you mean by this diagram represents, that we are going to discuss some afterwards, after some time. But first of all, what do you mean by resistance? When a current flows through any material or any circuit, it is opposed by a force of similar to that of mechanical friction. So this opposing force is called resistance, and the device who follow such characteristic is called resistor. Okay, so I repeat the definition again. When a current flows through any material or any circuit, it is opposed by a force of similar to that of mechanical friction. So this opposing force is called resistance, and the device who follow such characteristic is called what? Resistor. So generally, resistor is measured in terms of ohm, and it is available in two different types, that is fixed type resistor and variable type resistor. So again guys, we have to discuss two different sub parts of fixed type resistor. Fixed type resistor are specially called carbon resistor. Okay, and there are one more type of resistor is called, it is called wire wound resistor. It is also again a fixed type of resistor. And in variable resistor, we already studied in 9th and 10th standard, that is called potentiometer. Variable resistor means what? Potentiometer means it opposes the flow of current according to our adjustment. So the best example of potentiometer is what? Our fan regulator. So when we turn on the, when we switch on the fan, and if we change the current position of our regulator, fan regulator, suppose if it is on, it points to on 1, then what happens? Your fan rotates with some particular speed. And suppose if I change its position from 1 to 2, then you clearly observe that the speed of fan gets increased. And similarly, suppose if I am going to move the pointer on 5, then what happens? The fan rotates with highest speed. Means what? In that case, the resistance from that device is 0. So that's why it try to send and passes the full flow of current through that fan. So that's why it works with its best and it rotates with highest speed. Got it guys? And when, suppose if I am going to move from 5 to off, then what happens? So in that case, there is no flow of current, or no flow of current passes through the fan, and your fan get switched off. Even then your switch is turning on. Still, if your regulator is on off mode, then fan is still not in working condition. That is also in off mode. Okay. So potentiometer is the biggest example of variable resistor. In fixed type resistor means what? Its resistance, its opposing capacity is fixed. So how can we identify the capacity of resistor, whether it is available in this portion or this value. So to identify the value of particular register, we have to take the study of our carbon register. That is, we have to study the barcode of register. So this diagram represents a fixed type register, or it is also called carbon register. Why? Because it is made up from carbon. And if we see the cost of these registers, so if you visit the market, so if you try to purchase, suppose hundreds or thousands of registers, so you have to pay very less amount of money. So these are so cheap available in a cost, and means in small quantity of money you will purchase a huge amount of registers. So we can find out the value of particular register with the help of by studying this barcode. So a normal typical carbon register consists of 4 different color bands. Now how to identify, how to read the color code? So we have to read the barcode from left to right. Means a typical carbon register consists of 4 different color bands. So in that, first 2 color band represents color code. First 2 color represents color band, means value of that particular register. Then third color band represents multiplier, and the last color band represents tolerance, means manufacturing of that company. And when they manufacture a particular register, tolerance means what? That might be adjustment, plus or minus, means close to that particular value. Means say for example, if I want to create a register having capacity 5 kilo ohm, so it is not exactly 5 kilo ohm, it is close to 5 kilo ohm, means 4.9, 4.8, or it may be 5.1, 5.2. So it is called what? Tolerance, means adjustment. So value is adjusted by this tolerance band. So these are the 4 different bands available on our typical register. So how can we check, or how can we find out the value of this color band? So for that purpose, we have to study one chart. So with the help of that chart, we can easily find out value of any register. Okay guys, so, and also one more thing, from examination point of view, this topic is very important. Means there are question asked in your examination, like what is register, explain different types of register with suitable example. So this is one of the our first theory question. And second question is, what is register? Explain color code chart of register that helps to find out the value of a particular register. So this is our second theoretical question. So that chart I am going to draw on a board, so that's why it is more clearly and easy to understand for you. And the third question that we are going to discuss, which is based on this register, that is finding the value of a particular register. So generally I am going to draw 4 different columns. So our first column represents color. Then digit. Then third column multiplier. And my last column represents tolerance. Got it guys? So first column represents color band code, then digit, multiplier and tolerance. So now we are going to see how many colors are available and how to remember these colors. So let me see one by one. So I have drawn the chart of our color code. So we have these many colors. So our first color is black, then brown, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, violet, gray, white, gold, silver and no color. So there might be a confusion, sir, how these colors, the sequence of color is remember, how we can remember? Because what happened, according to the sequence of color, we have to remember the digits, and even though we have to remember the multiplier column. So how can we remember this? So our color starts with black, brown, red, orange, so in this fashion. So I will create one word, means we'll take the first letter of every color. So that's why from that first word, we just try to make one sentence. So that sentence is easy to remember to us. So that's why we can easily find out the color code. Why is it so, guys? Because if such types of question ask in your examination, find the value of color code. And unfortunately, suppose if you miss the numbers or if you miss the sequence of that particular color, then your answer will be definitely turns wrong and you will get 0 marks for that question. Got it? So let me take single word from each and every color. So we'll try to make one sentence. So our first color is black. So that's why I'm taking the word B from first, then from brown, again, I'm taking word first character B. Then from R, red, I'm taking R. From orange, O. From yellow, Y. Then green, G. From blue, we have taken B. From violet, we take V. Again, gray, G. Then white. Is that clear? So this is the single word character I have taken from each and every color word. So what it becomes? B B R O Y G B V G W. So how can we construct a word or a complete sentence from this particular single character? So what is our first word? BB. So BB Roy, Great Britain, very good writer. So this single statement is very easy to understand. So how can we remember the sequence of this color? So based on only one sentence, BB Roy, Great Britain, very good writer. But you have to note that your color always start with black, then brown, then red, then orange. And then what happened? First green comes and then gray comes. So there might be a confusion between the position of gray and green. So in that, first you have to remember that first green color comes and then thereafter gray color comes. Is that clear? So how can we remember this, the sequence of color? By using, remembering this word, that is BB Roy, Great Britain, very good writer. So by remembering this sentence, we can remember the sequence of this color code. And if you see the digit column, so you have to start from 0 to 9. Means for black, color is represented by 0, then brown is represented by 1, then red 2, orange 3, yellow 4, then green 5, blue 6. In this way, we have to see the what is value for last color, that is white 9. And if we see, there are 3 more colors. So which are those? Gold, silver and no color. So these 3 special colors are used in 4th band of our resistor. So it represents tolerance. So that they have no value in digit column. But if we see the multiplier column, means generally what happened, to find out a color code of any resistor, we have 3 color bands are there. 4th color band represents tolerance. 1st 2 color band represents digits. 3rd column represents multiplier. Is that clear? So to represent our first 2 color, we have always choose from this column digit, and in 3rd column multiplier is there. So what is the multiplier value for black? Its value is 0. So that's why I'm putting here 10 raised to 0, and we know that the value of 10 raised to 0 is 1. Then for brown, digit value is 1. So that's why 10 raised to 1. So we know that 10 raised to 1 is 10. Then in red, the value is 2. That's why I'm put it here 10 raised to 2, 10 raised to 3. In this way, 10 raised to 9 is there. But in multiplier column, we have the value for gold, silver and no color. For gold, we have value 10 raised to minus 1. That is 1 upon 10. That is called what? 0.1. Is that clear? Then for silver, it is 10 raised to minus 2. That is 1 upon 100. That is 0.01. And for no color, there is no any multiplier number is there. Okay, our last column is what? Tolerance. So as I told you, special 3 colors are used to represent tolerance value, means adjustment value. So that's why for normal color, they don't have any tolerance value, but it is अवेलेबल ओनली एंड ओनली फॉर थ्री स्पेशल कलर्स, दैट इज गोल्ड, सिल्वर एंड नो कलर. फॉर गोल्ड वी हैव प्लस और माइनस 5% टॉलरेंस वैल्यू, फॉर सिल्वर प्लस और माइनस 10% वैल्यू, एंड फॉर नो कलर प्लस और माइनस 20% वैल्यू. बट देर इज अ बिग क्वेश्चन इन आवर माइंड, नो कलर मीन्स वॉट? सो यू से दैट नो कलर, एज द नेम सजेस्ट, नो कलर मीन्स वेदर इट इज अ पर्टिकुलर कलर और वॉट. सो नथिंग गाइस, देर इज नथिंग टू वरी अबाउट इट. सो जनरली फॉर अ स्टैंडर्ड रजिस्टर वी हैव फोर डिफरेंट कलर बैंड्स, बट इन केस ऑफ नो कलर फॉर्मेट मीन्स वॉट हैपन, ऑन आवर रजिस्टर ओनली थ्री कलर बैंड अपीयर्स, मीन्स फोर्थ टॉलरेंस बैंड इज नॉट अवेलेबल. सो इन दैट वी एज्यूम दैट आवर फोर्थ बैंड रिप्रेजेंट्स नो कलर. गॉट इट गाइस? सो इन दिस वे यू कैन रिमेंबर द चार्ट एज वेल एज इट्स करस्पॉन्डिंग वैल्यूज. सो नाउ वी फोकस टू ऑन आवर प्रॉब्लम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. सो वी हैव टू स्टडी टू डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम. सो इन फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम वॉट वी हैव टू स्टडी, इन दैट केस डिफरेंट वैल्यूज ऑफ पर्टिकुलर रजिस्टर्स आर गिवन. सो वॉट इज आवर जॉब? वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट देयर कलर कोड. वी हैव टू फाइंड मीन्स कलर इज गिवन, वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट इट्स इक्विवेलेंट वैल्यू फॉर दैट रजिस्टर. एंड द सेकेंड टाइप इज वॉट? रिवर्स थिंग वी हैव टू डू, मीन्स वैल्यूज आर गिवन, वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट इट्स कलर कोड. गॉट इट गाइस? सो लेट वी फर्स्ट मूव ऑन टू आवर फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम, दैट इज फाइंडिंग द वैल्यू फ्रॉम गिवन कलर कोड. ओके, बट यू ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट विदाउट दिस चार्ट इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू और टू फाइंड आउट द कलर कोड ऑफ एनी गिवन रजिस्टर. सो लेट वी टेक द एग्जाम्पल. सो वी टेक द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम. सपोज इफ आई एम टेकिंग द फर्स्ट कलर बैंड इज रेड, then brown and suppose yellow, and my fourth color is suppose silver. So these four colors appears on my register, so I have to find out its value. So how can I find out? So we know that first two color represents what? Digits. Third color represents multiplier and the fourth one represents tolerance. So what is the value for red? So first of all, what I'm trying to do, I'm just trying to write it down, all the colors in this fashion, red, brown, yellow and silver. So this is given. So what to do? What is the value for red? So it is 2. So that 2 value you have to represent over here. Then second color is what? Brown. So brown is represented by 1. Okay, then third column is what? Third color is what? Yellow. So in that third color it is represented by multiplier. So for value of multiplier for yellow it is 10 raised to 4. So how can I write like this? 10 raised to 4. And the last color band represents tolerance. So in this case, in our problem, they given silver. So tolerance value for silver is what? Plus minus 10%. So you have to write down like here, plus minus 10%. So in this way we have to combine all these numbers. So you have to write down like this: 21 into 10 raised to 4 ohm plus minus 10%. So this is the value for given resistor. Is that clear? So you can even furtherly modify it also, means we know that kilo ohm, mega ohm. So kilo ohm means what? 1 kilo ohm is equivalent to 10 raised to 3 ohm. And 1 mega ohm is equivalent to 10 raised to 6 ohm. Got it guys? Kilo ohm represented by 10 raised to 3. Mega ohm represented by 10 raised to 6. Okay guys? So in this way, we have find out the value of any resistor. So let me take some different example. So somewhat we'll take some, suppose different kind of problem is there. So we take the color, first color orange, then suppose next color we are going to use blue, third color suppose if I am using gold, and fourth one is suppose if I am choosing no color. Means in general on our register only three color bands appears, means fourth one is disappear, so that's why we assume that it is no color. So what is our first job? We have to write down the values for these colors. So what is our first color? Orange. So orange digit value is 3. Then blue, blue is represented by 6. Is that clear? And gold. So for gold, we have to see the multiplier column. So what is the value for gold? It is actually 10 raised to minus 1. 10 raised to minus 1. And for fourth band, we have to see the value of tolerance. That is, for no color, the value is plus minus 20%. Is that clear? So how can we combine this? So we can write down like this, 36 into 10 raised to minus 1 ohm plus minus 20%. So even though we can also furtherly simplify it like this, 3.6 ohm plus minus 20%. So you can write down answer like this also, or you can also furtherly simplify, and you can also write down the answer like this. Both the way the answer is correct. Got it, guys? So in this way we can find out the value based on given color code. The next type of problem is totally inverse method. Means what? In that case, they are providing the value, and what is our job? We have to find out its equivalent color code. So guys, you have to keep one thing in your mind. In your examination, especially in terminal examination, there is a specially 10 marks question asked on color code. Means you have to find out the value as well as you have to find out the color code. Two separate questions will ask for 5-5 marks. Okay guys, but one thing is what is the basic terms and condition for this? We should know the value of this color code. Means in general, we should have to remember the sequence of this color. So that's why we have create one word. And what is that word? What is that complete sentence actually? B.B. Roy, Great Britain, very good writer. So by using, remembering this complete sentence, you can try to understand, try to remember the sequence of this color. So let me see the different part of the problem is what. So we have discussed the first part, means we are going to find out the value. Now we are going to do the reverse process. Means value is given, and from that value we have to find out its color. So let me take the first example. Suppose if I have 37 into 10 raised to 6 ohm plus minus 5%. So this is the value given for a particular resistor. So what is my job? I have to find out its color value. So we know that. So yeah, we can write down like this. Okay. So it is more easy to remember or more easy to understand. So what is the value color code for 3? So 3 is represented by orange. Okay, and for by making more practice, okay, for 3 we have representing the color orange. Then next one is 7. So 7 is represented by color violet. Okay, now 10 raised to 6. So what to do? You have to visit the multiplier column and check the 10 raised to 6. So it is given for blue. And the last is plus minus 5%. So it is represented by gold. So what is your answer? Orange, comma violet, comma blue, comma gold. So this is the color code for given resistor. Got it, guys? So in this way, we have to find out the color code based on given value. Got it, guys? So if you have any difficulty regarding our today's session, please ask me or write down in comment section also, or you can also send your queries on our WhatsApp group. So what I will do, I will give you some different kinds of problems so that will more easier to find out the solution, or we can find out many value problems based on this chart. Okay, so I will give you approximately 10 questions. 5 questions belongs to find out the color code, and second type of question, find out the value. Got it, guys? So I hope so you are enjoying this lecture. Thank you.